Hi everyone, welcome to Bodyworks Prime. Today we're going over the origin, insertion and action of the plantaris muscle.
Here we can see a posterior view of the legs, and we can see the plantaris muscle in isolation. Deep to the plantaris we have the soleus muscle, which you can see pictured here. And now we can see pictured the gastrocnemius muscle. The gastrocnemius is superficial to the plantaris, so you can see the plantaris here, and it disappears behind the gastrocnemius, and then it resurfaces further down alongside that Achilles tendon. Now, the anatomical name for the Achilles tendon is the calcaneal tendon, and I've highlighted the calcaneal tendon here in green. Both the soleus and the gastrocnemius insert into the calcaneal tendon. And if you want to learn more about either of those two muscles, I'll put some links in the description box below. As for the plantaris muscle, it doesn't insert into the calcaneal tendon, but you can see it runs medial to it, to its insertion point down here on the calcaneus. As for the origin, you can see I've got that highlighted here in red, and that's on the lateral supracondylar line of the femur. So the lateral supracondylar line of the femur is just a ridge which runs up this section here. On the medial side, we have the medial supracondylar line of the femur, and again, that's another ridge which runs up this section here. Both those supracondylar lines meet in the middle and merge together to form the linea aspera, which is another ridge running up the centre of the femur here. Here we can see the insertion, marked out in blue either side. And that insertion is on the posterior surface of the calcaneus. The calcaneus is also sometimes referred to as the heel bone, and the plantaris's insertion point is just medial to the insertion point of the calcaneal tendon, which you'll remember we saw before highlighted in green.
So let's have a look at the actions next. So the plantaris muscle is crossing over two joints, the knee joint and the ankle joint. So it's going to have actions at both these joints. At the ankle joint, it's going to provide weak assistance during plantar flexion, which is essentially when the ankle joint extends like that. At the knee joint, it's going to provide weak assistance during flexion of the knee, which is when the knee bends like that. Now, I say weak assistance because the plantaris is a relatively thin muscle compared to its length. That's going to limit the strength and power it's able to provide, especially when you compare it to bigger and stronger muscles in the lower leg here, like the gastrocnemius and the soleus, or bigger and stronger muscles in the upper leg, such as the hamstring muscles. However, the plantaris muscle has been said to be an important muscle for proprioception. Proprioception is essentially your body's way of determining movement, actions, or locations. So essentially, it's providing sensory input. So if you've enjoyed the video, or you found it helpful, you know which buttons to press. Press those buttons down there. Really helps out the channel. Thanks very much for watching, everyone. See you all next time.